Hello friend, welcome back to my new lecture on innovation and startups using convergence of technology and industry 4.0. So I have already discussed about all the facts regarding to industry 4.0 and convergence of technology, but today with point of view of this innovation and startup, so I am taking this lecture. So basically, how we have innovated? We have innovated lots of things when we have started the civilization. That time we have started with the manual system. So you can see in this diagram, in this slide, we have been this type of manual system. And then again, we know the power of water and steam. Then we have started to develop or innovate some new kind of system. And then the new era came. Electrification and electric appliances and motor is the new innovation of this era, and then we have started assembly line production. So this was the big development from manual to, we have switched from manual to automated system to assembly line system. So this was the big development. So we have innovated so many things. So we are talking about innovation and startup. So how can we develop the new innovation? How can we develop our startups? So we are moving towards this direction. So this is very important. And you can see the development, the growth of the technology, how the technology moves around and how the technology moves towards this direction. And today we are in the era of the technology, we are in the era of Sophia. So how we came to this era and how the technology is playing important role and innovation is playing very important role. So motivating by this innovation and technology, we can start our startup and we can move towards the startup. So this was the theme of my lecture. So we have started industrialization hundreds or thousands years back. So it was the time of mechanization when we are saying about the industry 1.0, and we know that time steam engine, steam and water power and factory system, we know that time. And then came to the next era, that was the industry 2.0. That was the big development, and electrification is the big development of industry 4.0. So we have started that time mass production, assembly line production, electrification and globalization. So these all the things has been started during the industry 2.0, and suddenly came the new big development, that was computer. So it has started the industry 3.0. So computer, emergence of the internet, autonomous production, ERP and so many softwares has been started that time, and computer was the big development during the industry 3.0. And we have started globalization, we have started computerization all across the world and all across the industry. And now the time came to the cyber physical system, and that is called industry 4.0, and we are living in this era. So we have lots of technology, big data, we have been in artificial intelligence, we have robotics, we have internet of things. So these different technology, these technology and convergence of these technology, we are creating a new technology. So this was the big development, and we are talking this innovative era, we are talking knowledge innovation, and so many things we are talking about in this industry 4.0. So all the industrial revolution started with the introduction of a disruptive technology which acted as a change agent according to the industry. So this is happening in this era of industry 4.0. So that was my lecture. I am talking about innovation, startup, convergence of technology, industry 4.0. So we are talking about this convergence of technology means we are collecting, combining all the technology and making the new technology. So we are moving towards this direction. So this is industry 4.0, and you can see here the robots, they are connected with the sensors, and we are sensor based, we are IoT based robotics, we have artificial intelligent robotics, we are talking about this. So this is cyber physical system. So the definition of cyber physical system, you can see the definition of cyber physical system, where computing element, cyber physical system is a system of collaborating computational system controlling the physical entity means we are controlling all the physical entity by the computation, and we have been computation, we have been communication, we have controlling, we have information flow, and again we are using artificial intelligence also. So these are the development, and convergence of technology is very important right now. We are converging, we are combining different technology. And convergence of business, we are talking about convergence of business ecosystem, we are talking about convergence of people, application, thing, data, devices. So all the things we are combining and collaborating. So we have been lots of technology. We have robotics, we have natural interfaces, 3D printing, internet of things, cognitive system, next gen security. So these many technologies, and mobile computing, cloud computing, big data, social media. So we are combining and we are innovating towards a new direction, and towards the direction of this industry 4.0. and so these are the new development, and we have been many amazing fact that you can see here the iPhone, iPad, Kindle, 4G, Uber, Android, Instagram, Snapchat, WhatsApp, they are the essential part of our life, and before 2006 they are not heard by the humankind. So but now these devices are the important part of our life, and they are necessity of our life. And again you can see, and the telephone has taken 75 years to reach 100 million customer, and web has taken 7 years to reach 100 million customer, and Facebook has taken 4 years to reach 100 million customer, Instagram has taken 2 years to reach 100 million customer. While the game like Pokemon Go or game like PUBG, they are reaching 100 million customers within a month or within some days. So this is the speed of technology and how fast we are moving the technology. So keeping all the views in mind, we can move towards new innovation and new business. So we have moved from manual system to this e-system, manual system to cyber system, automated system, start AI based system. So the list is so long, and we are moving towards so new directions, towards new technology. So manufacturing, now the manufacturing is not this. This polytime creating manufacturing is not the part of our industry. So we are talking about this type of manufacturing, this robotics manufacturing. This is amazing. We are talking about digital manufacturing. We have been lots of robots. So we have to move. It is expected up to 2009, $135 billion will be invested on the robots. So why not we should move towards this business? We should start our startup towards this direction. We can start our unit, our business for the maintenance of the robot. So because companies are requiring the robot, we can develop the robot. So this may be our startup. So this is the direction. And big data, predictive analysis, virtualized processes, modeling and simulation, high performance computing, robotics, they all are part of this smart and digital manufacturing. So the digital manufacturing is completely changed, and physical system, smart component and connectivity computers, they are making this IoT and smart manufacturing product. So we have been mechanical and electrical parts, we have smart sensor, lots of sensors are there. We are using microprocessors, data storage in all the system, all the devices. We are using memory, we have been controlled, we have software, embedded software in all the system. We have different operating system, like TV has its own operating system, digital interfaces are there, wireless connectivity is there. So we are talking about this IoT, we are talking about the smart product, and this is the tomorrow, this is the future. We have been huge machines, we have been huge technology. So you can see here, one person today does the work handled by the 30 people 40 years ago. It means you can see this speed of mechanization. One person can do work of 30 people which is done by 40 years, up to 40 years, that work is done by one person in one day. So this is the speed, because we have been huge machines. So we know to these technology, we know to operate, how to operate these machines. So we have to train ourselves accordingly, and we have to start our training studio accordingly. We have to start our startup. These startup is based on this new technology. So we need, we are talking about Industry 4.0, we are talking about digital manufacturing, we are talking about the huge machines. So for this Industry 4.0, we require Worker 4.0. otherwise, these technology, who will operate this technology? So this is the big question. So we have to generate our human resource, our manpower accordingly. We have to train our manpower accordingly. So we require Worker 4.0. So this is very important, and this is very important term. We are talking about Education 4.0, we are talking about Industry 4.0. so our education system, our training and learning system is according to the Industry 4.0 demand, and our worker should be should fulfill, and worker is capable to operate the machine accordingly and technology of Industry 4.0. So we have been lots of technology Industry 4.0. These are the different technology of Industry 4.0: big data, augmented reality, additive manufacturing, cloud computing, cyber security, Internet of Things, system integration, simulation, autonomous robot. These are so many technology that are the part of this Industry 4.0. So the makers of this fourth industrial revolution, they are biotech, nanotech, neurotech, green renewables, ICT, mobile technology, 3D, AI, machine learning, robotics, sensor, sensing, space technology, drones. So if person is knowing all these technology, then he will be very easily, he will get the job. Otherwise, it is very difficult to get the job. So we have to train our human resource. We have to start our startups. We have to establish our startups according to this technology. Otherwise, we will not get the business. If we have to earn the business, we have to earn the profit, then we have to train ourselves accordingly. And our mission, cloud computing, is very important right now, and we are moving towards mainframe computer, to this cloud technology. And during ATEEZ, it was client server technology, but today it was cloud computing. So in between the journey of mainframe to computing, cloud computing, we have been web computing, we have client server computing, personal computing. So many things has been evolved in between the journey of this growth, but cloud is very powerful right now. Our devices are so powerful. We are talking about internet based computing. We have been lots of resources, software, information, but all are in the cloud, and we can rent them, buy them, and like electricity use grid, we are taking the electricity accordingly. We are taking the computing from the cloud, and this is the future, and this is the scenario. And we are talking about ubiquitous computing. Now the time of ubiquitous pervasive computing era, ubiquitous as well as pervasive computing era, we are talking about. We have been so many devices. Previously we have been limited devices. One device is used by many persons, but now many devices are used by one person. We have been devices in office, we have been desktop, we have laptop, we have mobile phone, we have tablet, so we have Kindle. So many smart devices are, we are surrounded by so many smart devices. So this is the future. So this is the new world where we need only one connection, and by getting one connection, we are connected with the whole world. So with this frustrating world, we have left behind this frustrating system, how to connect with the router, how to configure our hardware, and so many things are we have left behind. But this is due to this cloud computing. We are connected, we have server as service, we have cloud infrastructure as service, we have platform as service, we have software as service. So whatever software, platform, infrastructure we require, this is available in cloud, and we will pay that accordingly, and we will take the advantage of these services. And we have the power of thumb, and we have power of connection. So this is the future. And our devices, our mobile phone, our tablet or Kindle is so hot because of, they are connected with the cloud. So cloud is very important. So you can see here, these are some snapshots of the cloud. So these cloud centers, these data centers, the cloud is backed by the different huge data centers, and one data center is around 12 or 11 to 12 football ground. So these are the size of different data centers. Each data center is 11.5 times the size of football field. So this is the size of these data centers, and some data centers are established in Mars, and some are in the underground. Data centers are established by some company in Siberia, in Japan. We have been data centers, Japan underground data centers. So moving data centers, we have been moving data centers, and Microsoft has established its data center in cold Siberia because they are taking lots of energy. So this is the drawback and side effect of these data centers also. So automatic, for automatic cooling, the company has established their data centers on cold Siberia and Antarctica area. So these are the different data centers. IBM, Google has its data center on Hong Kong, Taiwan. Google is in Singapore, Microsoft is in Virginia, and Facebook has its North Carolina. So different data centers are established in the all across the world. Google has established its data centers under the sea. So these are the different data centers, and we are moving towards this new generation technology, this amazing technology. We have been moved, we have been innovated this Nokia phone to this smart phone. So Nokia has not changed the technology. So Nokia came in the condition of the bankruptcy. So but somehow Nokia has revived his business and came into streamline. But you can see here, if we are not changing ourselves, we are not innovating ourselves, we are not starting our innovative business or startup, so we will not survive. So this is the formula of survival, that we have to innovate regularly. We have to innovate. You can see the Google is innovating regularly, his devices, his system. Google is moving towards this machine learning, to this artificial intelligence. IBM is moving towards artificial intelligence because of, and this is the time of artificial, this is the time of Watson, this is the time of Sophia, this is the time of Ross intelligence. So these are the new technology. So we are moving towards this direction, and this mobile phone is used for integration of the information, and it can connect, it can control all the devices. So we have changed the model. We are going towards this big data and older model. Now we are not using this older model where some media channel and some new channel are producing the data, but today everyone is producing the data and everyone is verifying the data. So we have been huge amount of data right now, and we are talking about big data. We are talking about talking about the big information, big data of education information, climate information, social media site, digital pictures, GPS signal, purchase data, videos, YouTube videos. So we are creating huge amount of data, huge. We are collecting and we are generating huge amount of data. So we are moving towards big data, towards big big data, and where we have large volume of data, large velocity of data, large variety of data. So variety means different type of data we have, and huge volume of data we have. And velocity means 2 minutes is too late. So we are collecting and we are generating that much amount of data. So big data is one of the emerging area where we can start up our business, and we can establish our startup on big data also, because we have been lots of jobs in big data. We have the new terms we have, like terms like data scientist, data analyst. So these are the new terms. So we can start our training institute for developing the big data and scientists. So we have been this huge amount of data, email, ad servicing data, web analytics data, social media data. So Facebook is creating and generating huge amount of data, scientific instrument data, mobile devices are producing lots of data, sensor technology are producing the data. So this is the exponential growth of data. So this is called data, big data. And this is the study that the data recorded until 2003, that meant data in 2001 only 2 days we are collecting that much data in 2011, and however in 2013 same data, same amount of data is created every 10 minutes, and it is exponentially increasing. And right now maybe this that much data is we are creating that much data within a second. So this is the speed of data. So we have huge amount of data, so we have to handle this this data. So the older human resource is not capable to handle this data, so we have to change our human resource, we have to train our human resource accordingly, and the older one will not capable to handle all these things. So we have to establish our startup accordingly, so who can handle this data, and we have to need new softwares. We require new softwares which will cater the demand or according the time, and older machines are not capable to handle the huge amount of data. So we have to scale up our devices, we have to scale up our system, and we have to establish our system. Hadoop and Hadoop distributed HDFS, MapReduce like software are helpful to process the huge amount of data. So we have to learn the languages, and as well as Cassandra, Hive. So these languages are essential right now, and if we are not trained by these softwares, these languages, then we cannot establish our business or we cannot get the job accordingly. So big data require big network, so we have to be expert on the technology, and large scale data management is required. Now we can start our innovation on big data analytics, data science analytics, and how to manage very large amount of data. We have to think about this, and because data is an asset, so this is very important right now. So deeper customer knowledge, we have to we have huge amount of data, and we can, this is resource as well for us, this is challenge as well as, and we have resource also, so we can extract the customer movement and customer liking and disliking. So we can accurate marketing, we can, so that we can do the accurate marketing. So IoT is emerging area, and this is next generation internet technology. We are trying to automate our all the devices. We are automating our mobile phone, or more, or every mobile phone, every automobile, every door, every room. Like you can see, your mobile phone is semi, is partially automated, and it has different sensors, and these sensors are connected with the internet. So same way we are trying to connect every bed, chair, basket, home, office, building, hospital, everything we are trying to connect with the internet. So this is going towards, by this we are going towards internet of things, we are going towards IoT, towards complete automation. So you can see different devices also, and this is expected that up by the end of 2020, 50 billion people are connected, 50 billion connected devices are all over the world. However, the population of the world is 7.6 billion. So it means that per person connected devices will be 6 to 6.5. It means 6 to 7 devices, each person having 7 to 6 devices. You can see you have been lots of sensor devices, that your fitness band, your smartwatch, your mobile phone. So you can see some devices we are wearing and we are using these devices, but in future we will use more devices. So we will have more technological devices. Google is doing lots of trial on this driverless car, and Microsoft has establish a security guard, as a robot as a security guard. So we are having nano robots, we are having mobile phone, and this mobile phone is equal to 14 gadgets. It's amazing devices, and we can do lots of things by one mobile phone, like eye examination, heart monitoring, air view. We can take air view and air examination, eye examination. So air view, we can glucose, we can monitor glucose. So this, by using different accessories, we can use these mobile phones in different purposes. And mobile is used for the smart x-ray, and smart pills directly connected with our mobile phone. So we can do all these technology, and we have been sensor all across the world, and now we are talking about the sensor as service, like infrastructure as service, platform as service, and software as service. Now we are talking about sensor as service. The cost of sensor is going down day by day, the speed of microprocessor is increasing day by day, and the speed of internet is also increasing day by day. So this all makes possible this Internet of Things. So IoT, complete automation. So you can see all the devices in day by day use this smart sugar check machine, and this is wireless connector, internet connectivity, ISDN system and router system, and we have been a smart watch, we have been a smart camera, we have been a smart electric appliances, we are using smart mobile, smart fitness band, smart watch. So we are using partially these devices, but when they these all devices are connected with each other and they will work as a whole, so this will call completely, this is called Internet of Things. So we have been all other more devices like smart coffee maker machine, smart AC, smart door. So you can see these example in your life. You can see these example on hotels, and some company has given the ad that the person, husband and wife, while moving from their office, they are switching on their AC of their home, and when they reach their home, then they find that room is already being cold. So this is the system, this type of the system, and sensor based electric lights are possible now. So you can see on the TV ad the electric sensor based electric lights, movement which are sensing your movement, that as you enter in the room the light automatically get on. So this is somehow, this is the example of IoT, Internet of Things. So we have been machinery on agriculture field, we are using IoT in all the field. We have been different machinery in agriculture field, so we can control all these machinery through sensor, through IoT. Sitting inside the home, we can operate these machinery, or we can operate our tractor while sitting inside the home. So this is possible right now because we have GPS, we have sensor, we have internet. So wirelessly we can connect from inside the home, inside the office, we can operate these machines. So this is possible right now, and lots of sensors are there. We have a smart irrigation system, when to re-irrigate, when to re-fertilize in our agricultural field. So it is possible right now, and machine will automatically sense, automatically do all the things. And we have been newer systems, so you can see here we can develop, we can start our startup like that. So this is the smart innovative machine, solar panel is attached with this system, and this is smart irrigation system. The system moisture sensor is there, and moisture sensor is sensing the moisture of the field, and accordingly it will start the irrigation system. This is a small irrigation system, so it will not waste the water. So this type of system are has to develop. This is the need of the time, so we can start our startup in this direction also. And smart charging station, so we are talking today we are talking about this electric car and electric vehicle. So smart charging system is the requirement of the future, and we are talking about this smart home where all the things are controlled by this mobile phone. Suppose we have parked our car in parking area or in a garage. Suppose the car is by chance the car we forgot to close the car any door of the car, so automatically it will send a message to our mobile phone, and it will send the alarm in our mobile phone that the door is opened or something is opened here. So this is the whole system, this is the complete home automation. So this is the also use of this IoT, and you can see here in this example the car, automobile, in the field of automobile we can automate the complete things. Suppose this is completely based on automation, this is completely based on IoT, Internet of Things. Our car is going on some tour, we are moving through our car, so car having the sensor, and a car will automatically sense when to refuel, and it will automatically sense the pressure of the tire and automatically suggests us the maintenance station, nearby maintenance station and petrol pump. And in case of any adverse situation, it will directly inform to the police station and police team will directly came to that site. So so this type of the automated system is the deed of the time, and we will move towards this direction. This is the one of the example where Heathrow Terminal 2 having these smart loops, and they are automatically cleaning accordingly, and in case of any problem, so they will alert the maintenance crew. So people's movement and bathroom flow will automate it, and can alert maintenance crew if there is an problem. Otherwise, they will work accordingly, and there is no manual staff is required to clean these bathrooms. So these are the automated system which is going towards, which is implemented and which is been installed in all across the world. And this is the future, and in future this type of system will be more and more used. And along with the Internet of Things, we are talking about the newer concept, people connecting with the thing. So you can see here the people are connected with the things through smart sensor and through internet. So a smart ECG sensor is attached in the body of the human, and there are many motion sensor which is attached in foot or in his hand. So accordingly it will sense the inside condition, biological condition of the human. So in case of any adverse condition, suppose the blood pressure level and heartbeat is suppose suddenly it increases the heartbeat, so it will sense accordingly, and it will send it to cloud, and cloud based software, as well as they are connected with the hospital and databases and different platform, this different framework. So automatically they will calculate that any adverse, they will sense any adverse situation. So they will find the ECG as well as other required reports, and if they find that a person is in an adverse condition, that accordingly they will send the message on our in our mobile phone that the heart attack, the forecasting of heart attack and forecasting of any adverse condition. So this is the system, and this will alert us. This type of system is required. So we have also done in this direction, in IoT direction, automated IoT based smart water assessment system. So here we have used different sensors to judge the quality of water. Basically it was developed for Nainital Lake. So we have been different sensor, we have been Arduino, we have been LCD, GSM and monitoring center. So we are directly finding the quality of water of Nainital Lake and Bhimtal Lake. So this we have done, and we have applied this for project patent. So this type of the system, this type of startup we can develop, and these are very beneficial in field of agriculture. We can develop this type of startup, and this is the time of learn, unlearn and relearn. So innovation is very important, and new knowledge is very important. So whatever we are learning today, this will be useless after some time. So we have to unlearn that technology and relearn the new technology also. So this is the time, this is the need of the time. And we are talking about man-machine fusion. Man is not powerful, too powerful this time. If man and machine, they are collaborating with each other, then they will be powerful. So fusing of the physical, digital and biological world is making man more powerful. Man-machine, we are talking about the man-machine interface and man-machine supremacy. If man with machine is supreme right now. So if we know the technology, then we are the supreme. If you know we are collaborating with the machine, we are knowing the new technology, then we are powerful. So this is the time of SOCIA. SOCIA is the big development for the computer scientists. So we are talking also about this cloud-based robotics. Robotics is very important, and cloud-enabled robot. Previously we are talking about the only robotics, but now we are talking about the remotely we are operating our robots. So this is cloud-based robotics, and these all are the Industry 4.0 technology. And AI, and we are doing wonder on AI in speech recognition. The system and machine directly recognizing the voice of human. So this is the time. And Alexa, Siri, Google Home, they are very popular right now. Google is a software company, but Google is producing driverless car, Google is producing Google Home, Amazon is producing Alexa. So these are the product of these companies. So they are doing their business, they are establishing their startup in this direction. So we have to innovate and we have to think where the world is going, where the technology is going. So accordingly we have to start our startup. So this is amazing. IBM has done IBM Watson 3D printer is amazing. We can develop any type of the safe. You can see here the different safe which is developed by the 3D printer, and its cost started by the 50,000. So it is not too costly. So we have to suppose we have established our startup on this 3D printer by using this 3D printer. Suppose we have been for 3D printer and we are developing different types of shapes in any city. So this business will be the hit business. Machine learning, 3D printing, cottage industry, backyard, augmented reality. So these are the new concept. Computational thinking, robotics, these are the new concept. We have to train ourselves and we have to develop or we have to start our business on this direction. So this is the example where a cupcake machine, a 3D printer is established in actual cupcake ATM that was Davis. That Davis called a confectionery 3D printer. There is a Sprinkles cupcakes ATM in several cities in the United States. So this type of the 3D printer are established in different cities of the United States. So this is the time, this is the requirement. So when we can prepare coffee by the machine, why not we are preparing pizza by the 3D printer? Why we cannot prepare a chocolate by the 3D printer? So this is the future, and we are doing 3D printing and 3D knitting by the printer. We can prepare clothes by the 3D printer. We have been drone. We are using massively drone in all the field. We are massively using drone in agriculture field, drone in forest, drone in security. So these are the time. Bioscience is very important. And virtual reality is very important. TV was filled into our classes. So this is the slogan of this virtual reality. We can see, we can wear our mobile phone on our eyes. So this was the time. And cyber security is very important area. So as we are this, we are doing lots of online things in this crisis of this COVID. So but cyber security is very important. We are doing all the transaction electronically. So the expert of cyber security, expert of cyber expert, we require lots of cyber expert. So if we know all the technology, all the needs, then we can establish our startup accordingly. So guys, finally I will say that innovation is very important, and we have to if we are innovating and if we have new idea, then we can start new businesses and we can establish our new startup, and then we will otherwise will not get more revenue or more business. So business is based on new innovation and innovative idea, otherwise we will be not able to be collect or earn the business. So thank you guys, thank you very much. Finally, thanks for listening this video. Please do subscribe my channel. Thank you.